Artist Ernest Shaw gets deep in thought when he works on this mural.
I get an opportunity to contribute to a legacy of mural making.
His thoughts keep returning to another Baltimore muralist, the late Pontella Mason.
And he was very critical of my work as well. He was more like a teacher and a mentor. His main criticism of my work was that I didn't spend enough time on things like hands.
He thinks his mentor would be proud of what he's accomplished with the hands of the late civil rights icon, John Lewis. The mural sits on Carey Street in the heart of West Baltimore. It took 10 years of planning, meetings, and panels to decide what figures would go up on this outdoor canvas.
It's a public art project. It's not about what I want to do. You know, it's about what the community wants.
It was crucial to get it right because this replaces an iconic Baltimore mural, the Wall of Pride. It celebrated African heritage and leaders in the Black community. After 30 years, it had deteriorated.
It being refreshed in a new way, but with the same spirit and the same goals, I think he'd be happy about that. I know I'm happy about it.
Pontella Mason's widow, Deborah Mason, is part of the project. Her children are in Baltimore to see it.
Our family has been living the art adventure with him.
The fact that it's the active teaching tool it is that's the most important thing.
The figures on the wall represent Black leaders in activism, politics, literature, and music.
Kids living in a neighborhood, maybe they're 5 or 6, and they'll grow up here, and they'll be able to see people that, you know, maybe they want to find out what they did.
And the painting Michelle Santos is working on represents the arts. That's Pontella Mason.
She's doing a great job. She caught him. She captured him. That's him. It gave me chills yesterday.
They say it's bittersweet. His mural is gone, but his commitment to educating the community stays.
That's an incredible gift to his legacy.
In West Baltimore, Megan Pringle, WBAL-TV 11 News.